So fine. Have you started up writing your record at least? Tarun?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Yeah, he's on the way progress. Anyhow, we have to submit by the first week of June. So see that until then, all the experiments which are being asked, you people will be keeping updated. So there is some slight changes which has been received as per the requisition done by you people. I think one Jayant and Tarun also. So you people have needed some clarity related to the list of experiments which has to be conducted, right? So
Yes, ma'am.
yeah, so in that aspect I'll just share you. So minimum experiments which are there for our okay, so previously we had listed out 10 experiments for our lab internals, and the same experiments were supposed to be written in the record. So in that, no change in the aspect of writing the record. So you have to write all the four experiments in part A and all the six experiments in part B for the record purpose. And while writing the record, you will show the tabular column and a specimen graph you can just draw and show. So you are not showing any calculations, any readings, or plotting any graphs in the graph sheet because you haven't performed physically, right? So you will just demonstrate the neat sketches, the aim apparatus used, the procedure, the tabular column to take the reading, the formulas what you use to calculate the readings. And just in a plain sheet where you draw the sketch, there you can just show the graph. So which versus what you have to plot exactly. So only that much need to be shown in writing the record purpose for all the 10 experiments. So this is about the record. And please keep ready the certificate sheet, the index sheet, everything, all the writing work updated related to your record writing to be completed by first week of June. As per the due date told, you will be submitting. How you will submit, the means will be informed to you later. So this is about your writing part. And next coming to our lab internals, okay? So as per the mail received from the principal, you needed a clarity saying that only the experiments which were conducted in the laboratory plus two experiments which were done in online to be given. So as per that, okay, so all the six experiments in the part B will be there for sure, and only in part A, out of four which was first told for y'all for the internals, so we'll be having only two out of it. One is the strain gauge and other one is the load cell. Okay, so you'll be having the calibration of load cell instead of pressure gauge, and you will be having the strain gauge. So in strain gauges, we have three tabular columns, one for full bridge, half bridge, and quarter bridge. So you could be asked either the full bridge, or you could be asked either with the quarter bridge, or you could be asked either with the half bridge. So based on the experiment title given, you will be focusing on it. So you'll be having two experiments from part A for internals. One is the load cell and the other one is the strain gauge. And part B, which has been listed out here in the list, will be there for sure. All. So all were being done. Slip gauges, sine bar, bevel protractor, gear tooth profile, surface roughness, and optical flat. It is a simple instrument where you will just evaluate the fringes. So even the YouTube link for that has been shown to y'all. So where you will just identify the fringe pattern for the concave, convex, as well as the slip gauges, right? So this has been shown. So you will do all these experiments. So these are the list of experiments which will be coming for your lab internals. And for writing purpose, you have all. I hope now the list of experiments is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine, is it fine? Comfortable for y'all?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, one more thing. Like,
Yeah.
there were initially some of the experiments have already been evaluated.
Right.
Now, do we have to write them again or it'll be considered as done?
No, do you have the record with you?
No, ma'am. That's what I was asking.
Okay. No, the record, since it has been evaluated, so previous marks will be considered, but that is not with you right now. And do you remember the marks which has been obtained in those experiments?
I think you wrote down in your only the viva part was left, rest were full, all marks were full only.
Yeah, that's for the viva marks were left out. So figuring out is difficult because I haven't written, since the viva part was left out, I haven't assigned the final marks for each experiment. The viva marks was left out in the record. I told you people to prepare and come. You
Yes.
people did not turn up. If you would have turned up with that, hopefully I would have added the marks for all those experiments, at least for six. But still I remember who have submitted, who haven't, who were regular, who were not regular. Based on that could be considered. How many experiments was completed? All the six you had written and evaluated, Tarun?
Four in part B were written and evaluated.
Okay. What about the others,
Tally.
guys? Yeah, tally surf.
Ma'am, we just conducted that experiment that day, ma'am. Like surface roughness, when you told us to, like when you were assigning marks, that time we were doing that two
Okay.
experiments. So we did only
Okay.
four in the record.
On record, you have written only four. Do
Yeah, ma'am.
you have the record with you?
I have it, ma'am.
You have it. So those guys who have the record, kindly write it in the records. So only the problem with the people who don't have the record. So use some A4 sheets, at least the plain sheets, one-sided, so that at least you can stick on to the records if needed in actual to be submitted for the VTU in the later stage. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Plain sheets you do use to for completion of the records. One-sided, don't write both the sides. And staple and keep it for each experiments. So all the thing have to be submitted. So we'll inform how it has to be submitted later. So one
Yes.
humble advice, those who have record, carry out writing in the record only. Those who don't have, please write it in the plain sheet of paper. And after coming back, you please paste those plain sheet of papers to the record. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
I hope the records are there safely at the hostel.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then fine. So this is about the list of experiments what you'll be having for your lab internals. And then how it will be asked for you people to conduct. So as per the marks assigned, so total you have 30 marks. So in that, part A is for 10 marks, part B is for 10 marks, and Viva Voice is for 10 marks. So in part A, currently we'll be having only two. One is the load cell and the strain gauge. So either of the two, you have to demonstrate the procedure for one. Suppose if you get strain gauge, it could be either full bridge, quarter bridge, or a half bridge. And if you get load cell, so then load cell. So either of these two, you will get one. For that, you will be having 10 marks. How do you demonstrate calculation, tabular column, everything? If any experiment is associated with the graph, then you have to show the. If you don't have the graph sheets, just draw x and y axis. How will be the nature of the graph? At least with respect to the readings, you can show a rough graph in the sheet what you are using for the test. Okay, that much you can do it. I'm not insisting for you to take the graph sheets. If you have well in advance, use it. If don't, only in the sheet of paper where you're writing the procedure, calculation, and all, there only you just draw x-axis, y-axis, take the readings along x and y, just name one unit is equal to how much. Roughly, you show how the nature of the curve will be. At least that can be work, right? See that?
Yeah, ma'am, that's fine.
Yeah. So that other part you will take care. And later, part B, out of the six experiments, either of the one you will be getting. So anyone what you get for that, you will be demonstrating. So you have to demonstrate. If I give you a title for for the calibration of micrometer using slip gauge, you have to explain me what is the aim of the experiment, what are the equipments used, what is the procedure followed. Okay, so you will explain this. Along with that, you will explain the procedure even for part A. So you should explain the procedure for part A and part B orally. After you complete the oral demonstration explanation, then you have to take the sheet of paper. You have to write the tabular column. Okay, so we will provide you the input readings for that particular experiment which has been given to you. Okay, so based on the given input reading, you will calculate the rest part of the calculation in the tabular column and show and graph how does it look like based on which experiment you are getting. So once you are done with the demonstration, you will do the writing part, and within the given time period, you have to upload back to the Google Classroom. Okay, so the time when it's been commencing, I will inform you, and the duration of the test also I will inform you. So after completion of the experiment and writing part for uploading, and time period of 15 minutes will be given. So within that, you will see that you will scan and you will upload it successfully. So any paper which has been uploaded after the time which has been allotted will not be considered. So please be abide to the time which has been given, and please upload your scanned documents without fail within the given time slot. The time slot I will tell you in future. At least by tomorrow we do tell. So because we don't know during the lab internals whether there will be regular classes or not. So once that is being declared, so accordingly we will plan the time and schedule and we will inform you. So next, coming to the Viva Voice. So Viva Voice, what do you prefer? Any the theoretical Viva Voice questions could be asked from any of the list of experiments, or you want to be focused on the experiment which has been selected from your. Hello. So best option is, instead of changing the Viva Voice, so I will just frame out and Google form. So where the quiz set of questions will be assigned. So after you upload the scanned documents, you can start on with your quiz. Okay, so for that quiz, we will be having 10 marks assigned. So first you will demonstrate, and then you will write the tabular column, show the graph, how it looks. You will upload it. After the completion of uploading part, you kindly go for the Google form which is shared to you and submit the answers in it. For that you will be having 10 marks. So overall 10 plus 10 plus 10 totally will provide you 30 marks. So this is how the description of the IA marks will be for your lab internals. And then coming to the manual, just a second. So now you have the lab manuals with you, so which provides you the aim, apparatus, the theory part of it. So you can refer the theory content which is given in the manual for your Viva Voice preparation. I think that will not be sufficient enough. You can also go through your modules, respective one, if you need any in-depth information for your Viva Voice part. So the questions related to the Viva Voice will be asked based on the list of experiments which are assigned for your lab internals. Okay, 6 plus 2. So total 8. So on that only the questions will be asked for my batch. For B3 I am telling you. So for B3 batch, I will be providing you the quiz Viva Voice based on the list of experiments which are been assigned for your lab internals. So based on those experiments, you can prepare well in advance for your Viva Voice. For that, you can go through the theory content given in the manual as well as the textbook, and you can also refer the study material PPTs which has been shared to you all in the Google Classroom related to that specific experiments. And now, when I ask you, suppose you have got the experiment calibration of load cell to perform and demonstrate. So when I ask you to please explain the entire procedure or demonstrate how the calibration of a load cell will take place, so you have to tell first what is the aim, what are the apparatus used, okay, so what is the procedure followed. So before that, at least you have to speak 2 to 3 lines. What is the need for use of load cell? Some theoretical background before you start the procedure. You should be knowing for what purpose a load cell is being used. What is its end application? At least you should be able to tell me that much. Okay, so after telling about the load cell, why it is being used, what its function is basically, then you will tell me what is the procedure being followed in order to do the experiment, how to calibrate the load cell. So you have a step-by-step procedure which has been given to you all in the lab manual. So you can just go through it. Don't memorize and tell me the same thing. Please explain me in your own words. That shows how well you have understood. So please go through all the videos which has been shared in the playlist for MMM lab. All for 15 to 14 experiments are there. So kindly go through it. For the exam in lab internals purpose, you can just go for 6+2 and remaining rest, you please go through it at your free time. But I need the procedure step by step properly in your own words, not replicating the sentences which is being given in the lab manual. But for understanding purpose, please go through it. And then finally, the result, what you are getting, that you have to explain it. So here there will be a tabular column, right? So in the tabular column, you will be having the readings which will be displayed in the indicator for adding the weight in increasing order and in decreasing order. So what is the value we are getting in the indicator? So this increasing and decreasing order input values will be given from my end. Suppose if you have got this experiment. So based on the input data given from my end, you have to calculate the error value and error correction, what you are doing, whether it is negative to positive, whether it is positive to negative. So do the error correction, then you will show the percentage of error what you are doing. So all this calculation purpose you will be doing from your end. Only the input data for increasing and decreasing, which will be displayed by the indicator, will be provided from my end. Okay. So accordingly, after you get the readings, you have to at least draw roughly the graph, how it looks like. So you have 3 graphs for the load cell. One is indicator value versus the actual. So indicator value you'll be having and the actual value, what is being obtained. So you will draw it on the x-axis. Then you show how the variation you are getting. Later you do the correction, right? So take the correction value along y and actual value along x. And also you calculate the percentage of error. So percentage of error versus the actual value, you'll just at least show me a rough graph how it looks like. So this ends up with the load cell if you have got as a part of your experiment in part A. So this much you have to do. I will provide you the input data for the load cell. And similarly, the strain gauge you have. Yes. So if strain gauge comes across for you in part A, so you have to tell what is the aim of the strain gauge, what are the apparatus used, why the strain gauge is being used, what is its purpose, what is its application. At least 1 to 2 minutes of explanation related to the theoretical background you have to tell me, and you have to add on the application also. Not in depth, in brief you have to tell why it is being used, what is its application and what it is significance. So going for types of strain gauges along is not needed. Only the brief information related to that is enough. So you can get the viva voice based on the theoretical concepts later. And then the observation and calculation. If you get the strain gauge, this input data will be provided to you. The length of the cantilever beam, this one even you can be aware of, no need of me giving it. So these are the constant values. So you should be aware of length of the cantilever beam, how much it is, breadth of the cantilever beam, how much it is, and thickness of the cantilever beam is how much. What is the formula used to calculate the stress? You should be aware of. So all these are constant value except our F. So if you forget this equation also, you know this constant value, which is 5.5634 into F. But it is always better to go hand in hand with formula as well as the constant value and how you calculate the strain E. Indicator reading upon the bridge constant, this you should be aware of, and you should also be aware of the bridge constant values. What you take it for quarter bridge, you take 1, for half you take 2, for full you take 4. So these values you should be aware. So this data I won't be giving you, you should be knowing. So only I'm stressing you right now. So in strain gauge, you might be getting either full bridge, half bridge or quarter bridge. So based on the question asked, you just focus the procedure for that particular bridge condition. If I have asked you for full bridge condition, you have to explain the procedure for full bridge fully in your own words. If it is asked for quarter bridge, please tell me the procedure for quarter bridge. If it is asked for half bridge, tell me the procedure for half bridge. But this graph is common for all the three cases. So you have to show the graph stress versus strain for the assigned bridge condition, whether it is for full, yeah, half, yeah, quarter bridge. And any one of the tabular column you have to show by default. So that could be for full bridge, half bridge, yeah, quarter bridge. So based on the question asked, I will give you the force applied in terms of kg. You will convert that into newtons. I won't give you the converted value for newton. And I will give you the value of indicator reading, okay, which is not multiplied into 10 into 10 to the power of minus 6. You will multiply into 10 to the power of minus 6 to calculate the strain value. And then you will calculate the stress value. So to calculate the stress value, you should be knowing the length of the cantilever, the width and the thickness, which I told you right away, which is 5.5634 into force. So that constant into the force value you will take. Please don't take the value of force which is in terms of kg. You have to take the value of force which is in newton, what you have calculated. So submit that to get the stress in the unit newton per mm square. After you calculate stress, then you determine the Young's modulus and list out over here. So once you list out the Young's modulus, you will just show the graph. So graph is above strain, this one. For that full bridge condition, you'll just draw the value of stress along X and strain along Y and show the variation of your getting. And finally, you will show the result. For full bridge, what is the Young's modulus you are getting? If you are asked for half bridge, you will write for half bridge, what is the Young's modulus you are getting? For quarter bridge, what is the Young's modulus you are getting? So this is just an outer layer, how the all the equipments will be arranged in together. So if it is difficult to draw, you can just draw a box and show strain gauge indicator and just your strain gauge, a cantilever. This is the weight hanger. And just show the rough sketch of it. Yeah, for the lab internals, thermocouple is not there. So this is about the part A. Similarly, part B, I hope everything is done in the class. So no problem in part B. Only thing, the optical flat I have to tell. So you have calibration of micrometer using slip gauges. We have done this. You have drawn the graph, everything. So I hope for part B, you have the input data with you all, right? Hello, how many of you have records with you? Hello,
ma'am, input data we don't have for that optical flats, ma'am. Other than that, we do have for others.
Right. Only for optical flats. So for optical flat, input data is not needed. Yeah, for others you have, right? So is it necessary
Yes,
for
ma'am.
me to give the input data or you will take on your own?
For the exam, ma'am? For
Yeah, yeah,
now?
yeah. For no, no, for the lab internals.
Meaning you are telling that we should take the same input data what we took in the lab earlier for the lab internals, correct, ma'am?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, because many of them, it's always better I will only give the readings or else.
Yes, ma'am, because we did it in batches and different batches.
Yeah, different batches
readings,
have
ma'am.
different readings and many are not
Yeah.
having the records also. So I will give you the input data even for part B. Okay, so you will then calculate the remaining calculations. So that will be fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So profile projector we have done. So only the optical flat, even this was been done, gear tooth vernier caliper. Sine bar was done. Bevel protractor was done. Optical flat. So optical flat, it is just placing the convex, concave and slip gauge in the optical flat and getting the fringes. So how the fringes look like. So even in the video, what we have demonstrated, which is there in the playlist of YouTube channel. We have shown the fringe patterns. I have also shown the fringe patterns, how does it look, and also in the record, how the students have drawn it. So if you get optical flat as one of the instrument, one of the experiment, then you will explain what is the aim of the optical flat, right? What are the apparatus used? And some theoretical concept related to the optical flat. So after that, you will just come across the procedure what you have to follow to get the fringes. Okay, so first always you will place the you will make the instrument on. Okay, so it will be showing, since it is a sodium vapor lamp, it will be showing you yellow colors, orange color. So you please wait until it turns up to yellow in color. So first you will place the standard circular disc specimen, which is made up of quartz material. So it will be having a very smooth and flat parallel surface. So based on the standard specimen, when the color changes into yellow, you will place the concave lens. So after you place the concave lens, you will just press at one edge of the concave lens so that the fringes will be visible inside the optical flat. So you will see the fringes, how does it look like, and the same drawing part, you have to draw it in your sheet of paper. And similarly, you have to tell now that has been removed and concave lens has been placed. And after you placing, you will just press one end of the concave lens again. You will get the fringe pattern. How does it look? The same thing you will draw and show in the sheet. And if a slip gauge has been given, so you will place the polished surface on the optical flat. If you place unpolished surface on the optical flat, you won't get any fringes. In that case, you can show the fringe pattern for the polished surface, and unpolished surface, no fringe pattern will be there. So you'll just show a blank rectangular box for unpolished surface. And for polished surface, you will show the fringe pattern, how does it look. So it has been shown to you all in the video link already. So similarly, you please draw the fringe pattern. So only this part was not done. So that I'm explaining you right away. So there is no calculation, tabular column, anything for this. Previously, it was just a demo version, but in this 18 series syllabus, so this is an actual list of experiments under video. So if you get, you will be just showing the fringe patterns for the asked specimens. So for concave, convex, and the slip gauge. So that will be the result. So the given optical flats gave the bands as shown in the figure. So I'll draw the figure and just show the patterns. So demonstration for FCD-MM has been given already, but for lab experiment that is currently not there. But still you can go through the YouTube channel for your gain of knowledge. That might be helpful if we have the practical examination for your Viva Voice also, external practical examination. And measurement of surface roughness was also being done in the lab in college already. Then what else we have? Lathe tool dynamometer is currently not considered under the list. So leave it, and you will not be writing this in the record also. Lathe and drill tool.
Ma'am, so we should write only the experiments which are there in the list in the record, ma'am?
Yes, yes, the 10. Part A, 4 you have, and part B, 6 you have. So 6 plus 4, total 10 experiments.
Yes.
Should
and
be there
the
in your record.
Yes, ma'am.
And for exam, the and lab the externals you are telling. That will
yes,
be intimated
in
to
A.
you. In part A, in the the experiments what you're writing in the record, that will be considered for your lab externals when it happens. Okay, so now for lab internals, we are just considering 2 experiments which are done online from part A and 6 which was in actual done physically in the college.
Understood.
Yeah. And this one we have done.
Ma'am, one more doubt, ma'am.
Yeah, please.
Ma'am, during internals, what all we have to write, ma'am? All the graphs we have to draw are like something should be like theory should be less. What all should be there?
Until now, what did I explain you? First, suppose if I assign you load cell and in the calibration of the micrometer. Okay, so suppose 2 experiments I have given you for your lab internals. I'll ask
yes,
you to explain or demonstrate how the experiment is done. You will demonstrate me orally what is the aim, what is the apparatus used in the experiment, like, and what is the use of that particular instrument, application purpose and little theoretical background, and what is the procedure being followed. So this much you will explain me for one experiment. And similarly, if load cell is given for you in part A, you will explain the aim, apparatus, why the load cell is being used, what is its application, and what is the procedure followed to calibrate the load cell. Orally, you will explain me these aspects. After you complete your oral demonstration, you will take a sheet of paper and you will write the tabular column and the formulas which are being used. I will give you the input data. You will calculate the calculations and you will plot the graph. If you don't have the graph in the same sheet of paper where you are doing observation and calculation, there only you will plot x-axis, what are the values, y-axis, what are the values, and you show me the scale, 1 centimeter, how much you are taking the readings, inputs, and just draw and graph how much it is possible from your end without using a graph sheet. Okay, so after completing this for 2 types of experiments, one from part A and one from part B, you have to upload these sheets what you have solved after scanning into the Google Classroom. Clear?
Okay. Yeah, ma'am. Thank you.
And this work has to be completed within the given time slot period for your lab internals. If you are submitting late, then that won't be considered. We will get it is being submitted late because we will assign the questions within due date. So once that due date and due time has been crossed, it will show us as late submission. So we'll come to know that you have submitted late. So then it will not be considered. So see that you do it on time. So once this is done, Google Form will be there for your quiz. So you have to fill this quiz form. So that will be assigned for 10 marks. And that also within the given time period, you have to submit. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. So this all are being done. So that's what from my end. Any doubts, you can kindly ask me. So this all, and slip gauges, you just remember the slip gauge set for M83 is how much, M87 is how much. I won't be giving the values for these. And Viva questions, if you need to brush up and have an idea how does it look like, you can kindly go through the questions which is asked at the end also. I don't know how well it will be helpful to you all. Just for an guidelines and reference how the questions could be, you can just go through the list of questions which is provided at the end as well. So this is about the experiments, what we will be considering for our lab internals, what is the demonstration way you have to do it, how you have to upload, and how to fill the Google form, all this. Still you have any doubt, you are free to ask me any questions.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
Ma'am, in the lab record, we had already written four experiments in while the college days. So
right.
Can we write the other six experiments and scan and send them only?
Yeah, see, provided if the college opens, so what's the idea is we are asking you to write in the blank sheet of papers. And if the college is reopened, you can add on these sheets to your records in the later stage. If that doesn't happen, and if it is being asked to submit the entire copy of the lab record online by scanning through Google Classroom only, then you should be having all the experiments written at your end. And that should happen within the first week of June. So to be on safer side, it is better to write all the 10 experiments and keep it with you. If you would have had the record, then you would have continued in the record itself directly. So at the end stage, you should not be having any problem. When we ask you to submit, and if you don't have the beginning experiments written, which is already evaluated, then again, it will be time consuming for you to write in hurry-burry. So well in advance, you just plan accordingly to be on the safer side with respect to the situation which arise in future.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Anything else?
Ma'am, the experiments which we didn't perform,
yeah.
Should we just draw the blank tabular column and not write the data for it, ma'am?
Yeah, that's what I told you. Suppose if you have record, you will show the aim, apparatus used, procedure.